Hello, everybody. My name is GB. Welcome back to my channel. I'm laughing because this is not a video I ever imagined I would be making. Mostly because I didn't really know that these existed, but they do. This is a 5-pound bar. She's chocolate. I don't know what the inside looks like. I saved it to open on this video. I am never gonna eat this whole thing or, you know, find enough people to even eat this with me. So I decided to just make an ASMR video with it. So, I'll eat some of it along the way. But mostly I just gathered some different tools and we'll explore the sounds of chocolate and packaging and such. I thought it'd be fun to experiment. And this was given to me as sort of a gag gift, and it really is 5 pounds. It says it right here. That weight is 5 pounds or 2.26 kilograms. It comes wrapped just like a normal one does, but on the back, the nutrition facts, the serving size is 1/60th of the package, and there's 190 calories per serving, so do the math, and this could feed me for quite a while. Just no nutrients, really. A lot of milk, I suppose. Good thing I've been lifting. I can handle this. It's solid. It is a big hunk of chocolate. And I can't wait to see what it looks like unwrapped. Classic milk chocolate. I don't know if the 5 pound comes in any other flavor, like dark or almond or whatnot. Are you ready? Let's move the camera so that you all can see the important part of this video, which is the chocolate. So this package is quite crinkly. It sounds like your average chocolate bar, but I think we should flip it over, which is a Herculean task. Was actually re-gifted to me, sort of playing like a gift tag. Somebody was given this chocolate bar and they pawned it off on me. And I said, fine, allow me to make a video with it. And they thought that was a great idea. I say we take off the paper. I'm not sure if it's sticky all the way through. It seems like it is. Perhaps we'll just slide it out. Let's try that. So there's the paper. Here is the foil. You can see the reflection of my sweatshirt in it. Oh, I can smell the chocolate now. Take off these pieces of tape. Only a few things separating us from 5 pounds of chocolate. This weighs almost as much as a full-term human baby. I know people that were born 5 pounds. I can never do anything neatly. So I put down some wax paper so I can get this chocolate up here on the table. Are you ready? Chocolate that is pure. Not after we're done with it. Okay. I have a few tools. We have a shaver peeler. I have a stamper cutter. And I have a giant knife. So, let's experiment. First, have you ever heard the sound of chocolate tapping? It's so smooth, especially when you trace the letters. It's soft, and it smells amazing. All right, well, we've got to eat some. So let's get in with a knife and see if we can hack off a bit. I anticipate it's going to be harder than we think. Perhaps a big knife isn't the best. Oh, we got a chunk. I'm gonna eat a bit. It's definitely the Hershey's you know and love. We'll do a little bit of chocolate grating. I think that'll work just fine. And I think a bit of the shaving and carving. Sort of experimenting with what the chocolate will allow me to do. Before I head into some close-ups. I wonder if we could get a button of chocolate with this. This doesn't seem like it's strong enough. The chocolate is actually thicker than I anticipated. Let's get some good close-ups if we can. While I snack. On this. Okay, so all of these brushes are completely new and unused. So they're gonna be my chocolate brushes now. It helps me clean off. The chocolate dust, of course. The little detailed brush to get in the corners. It's shiny almost, isn't it? You can see the reflection of me in the chocolate. Okay. So I'm gonna get off a chunk. By making a ridge and then doing a break. So we've got our piece of chocolate and we're gonna make there's our block of chocolate. Now this we can see off to the side. But we have to brush it off. Already starting to get melty. I realize I probably should have a towel with me, or at least a rag, but we'll worry about that in a second. Now let's grate. Brush it off. Keep it clean. I want to do some chocolate carving with this tool. Oh, that works really well. We can get rid of the letters. quite easily. Yeah. So thick, the chocolate. It's pretty crazy. On the other side. Reminds me of the chocolate shavings that would go on top of, you know, fancy cupcake or something, fancy dessert. It feels very strange to be sort of destroying such a large piece of, like, food. But I feel like these sort of 5-pound chocolates, it's sort of like it's a novelty, because what are you supposed to do with it? It's really hard to eat. I feel like you need a whole party of people. And I'm carving and carving and carving. And we've barely scratched the surface, literally. Very interesting. I'm not sure that this is very easy to slice. But we have a nice big knife. And it makes a few decent cuts. I'm curious if serrated would be the way to go here. truly, I just want to put this nap. I think I could snap it. I don't think I actually want to snap this, do I? So, I broke the chocolate in two hefty pieces. And let's flip this over. Get the pure side, the smooth. You can sort of see how the chocolate must have been made. Just like poured into the molding. I have a fork here. I just want to make some lines. Like a chocolate Zen garden. Of chocolate shavings. And chocolate gets small and delicate. Melts very fast. It's fluffy. I actually can't eat that much in one sitting. I do think I found the secret to cutting into this giant behemoth, the serrated knife. Works much better. Which is good because it's smaller. Less scary. These chunks are just starting to fall out. I could cut out an entire checkers board worth of chocolate chunks when your opponent checkers you. You have to eat your chocolate. What is it called when you jump someone in checkers? I don't think I've played checkers since I was like a little kid. Be a good way to get the stomach ache really fast. Beautiful masterpiece. You can make some really good s'mores with this. I'm sure I'll save all this to use in baking. You can make chocolate chip cookies with the biggest chocolate chips. The thing that impresses me is really the width, the depth, the thickness. And you can't see that. Good job, GB. There you go. It's definitely wider than my finger. Little house. I don't know if you guys can't tell, but I've never owned a 5-pound bar of chocolate before, and I don't know what to do with it. Well, that's not so bad at all, is it? With a little boop roof on top. Clean up my workspace. This is how you get ants. Thank you, Hershey's Chocolate, for unknowingly providing me with night's entertainment. Thank you to the person who gave me this gift. I would like to know what other people who have received the 5-pound bar of Hershey chocolate did with said chocolate. But I will be packaging mine up for future snacks and baking. It doesn't look nearly as neat as it did in the beginning, did it? A little bit messier now, but the contents are the same. in it, everybody. Thank you for indulging me in this experimental video. I think next time we'll do something a bit more traditional. But I hope you enjoy nonetheless.